Hello everyone, myself Professor P.G.Chitte, working in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology. In this session, we will learn the methods of taper turning. So there will be the two sessions, taper turning 1 and taper turning 2. So in this session, what we will learn? These are the learning outcomes. So the students will be able to explain the different methods of taper turning cutting operation on the job. Also, they can solve the problem based on the methods of taper turning operation. We will have a quick recap of the third session, and after that we will move towards the taper turning operations and their methods. Now, what we have learned in the third session? We have learned the different lathe operations. Like there are the external cutting operations like turning, facing, taper turning, threading, also parting off operation, knurling operation. These are the external cutting operations. There are the different internal cutting operations like drilling, boring, internal threading operation. These are the internal cutting operations. You can see the different figures here. This is the figure of the facing, where the tool is having the motion parallel to the axis of the rotation. Whenever there will be the relative motion between the tool and the workpiece, there will be the cutting operation. Here the diameter will be reduced. In the facing operation, there will be the diameter will be reduced. In the facing operation, the tool is moving perpendicular to the axis of the rotation. The workpiece is rotating and the tool is moving in the perpendicular to the axis of rotation. Here the length will be reduced in the facing operation. This is the boring operation, which is the internal cutting operation, where suppose you want to enlarge the hole which is already drilled with the help of drilling operation. So suppose you want the enlargement of the hole, yes, you can provide the boring operation. Boring bar is used and the boring tool is attached to the boring bar. This is the drilling operation. Suppose you want to provide the hole on the maybe the workpiece. So this is the drilling operation. You can see the particular animation of the knurling tool. The knurling tool is there, which is fixed in the tool post. And here the tool is moving perpendicular to the axis of the rotation. And this one is last one will be the parting off operation. Parting of operation is the separating the workpiece from the raw material. So these are the particular lathe operations. Now, just go through the question. Identify the following lathe operation, which is shown in the below here. Just think about this question. We have discussed this already. Now, in this session, we will learn the taper turning. What is meant by taper turning? What are the different methods of taper turning? Taper means a conical shape workpiece. You can see the conical shape workpiece, which is having a two diameters. D1 and D2 are the two diameters. D1 is the major diameter, D2 is the minor diameter, and the taper will be D1 minus D2, means the difference between the two diameters, that is D1 and D2. So that is called as taper. Means you are having the slope here. If suppose you are having a very simple job, that is called as a very cylindrical job. With the help of facing or maybe the turning, you can provide the cylindrical type of job. But whenever you are having the conical type of shape, in that case, you have to use the taper turning. So this will be the total taper, that is D1 minus D2 divided by alpha. Alpha is your taper angle. Alpha is your taper angle. L is the taper length. So taper angle is equal to tan alpha is equal to D1 minus D2 divided by 2L. So alpha is equal to tan inverse of D1 minus D2 divided by 2L. Now, there are different methods of taper turning. First one is Telstock-Sater method, by swiveling the compound rest. using the taper turning attachment, there is a different attachment for the taper turning operation, and using the form tool or maybe the broad nose tool. So we are dealing with the two sessions for the taper turning. So in the first session, we will see the tailstock setor method and a form nose tool method. Now, what is taper turning by tailstock setor method? As we know that with the help of taper turning, you can get the conical type of workpieces, the cylindrical conical type of workpieces. Now, this is a dead center, which is a part of tailstock. Now, this is a headstock part where the live center is there. This is the lead dog and this is the driving plate. At the end of the driving plate, the lead dog, the tail of the lead dog is attached here. Now, so what type of taper we can get here? Suppose you want to provide the taper turning operation very short length. In that case, you can use the taper turning by tailstock setor. Now, what is the working principle? So you can say, so there is a nut which is provided to the tailstock, and you can loose that nut and you can slide that tailstock maybe the away from the operator or maybe towards the operator. If suppose you want the larger taper, so you should take the tailstock away from the operator so that you can get the larger taper turning operation. And if suppose you want the taper turning operation for very short length or maybe the short angle, in that case, take a tailstock or slide a tailstock just towards the operator by losing the nut which is present in the tailstock, and the tool will be moving parallel to the axis of the rotation, but the workpiece will be having the angle because your dead center is somewhat maybe in the inclination by alpha angle. So whenever the tool is moving in the parallel to the axis of the rotation of the job, there will be the taper turning operation and you will get the conical type of job. So very simple derivation regarding the taper turning by tailstock setor. So we are knowing that x is equal to L sine alpha. This is L sine alpha, where it's x is equal to length of the tailstock setor. We have to calculate the length of the tailstock setor, but here alpha is very small. That's why sine alpha is equal to tan alpha. So we can call that as x is equal to L tan alpha. Also, we know that the taper angle is equal to, or the tan alpha is equal to D1 minus D2 divided by 2L. So with the help of this, replacing the tan alpha by this equation or the term, so x is equal to L into D1 minus D2 divided by 2L, and x is the length of the tailstock setor. And x is the length wherever you want to slide this tailstock, maybe the away from the operator or maybe the towards the operator, that is the length of the tailstock setover. So this is regarding the taper turning by tailstock setover. We'll see the some of the examples. Calculate the tailstock setover length for taper turning operation such that the two diameters are 80 mm and 50 mm, where length of the job is the 300 mm and length of the tapered portion is the 200 mm. You are having the D1 is 80 mm and D2 is 50 mm and capital L is 300 mm and small l is equal to 200 mm. We are knowing that x is equal to L into D1 minus D2 divided by 2L, and by that we can get x is equal to 15 mm by providing the values in the this equation, and which will be length of the tailstock setover. This is another example. We are having D1 and D2, that is 3 by 2 inches, and this is 5 by 4 inches. Capital L is, that is the total length, that is 10 inches, and small l, that is the tapered portion length, that is 5 inches. Providing these values in x, that is L is equal to, or L into d1 minus d2 divided by 2L, we are getting the 0.25 inches, that is the length of the tailstock set over. Now, the taper turning by the form or the broad nose tool. So, this is the second method. In the first method, we have learned that the taper turning by the tailstock set over. In this session, we will learn the taper turning by form tool or maybe the broad nose tool. This is the broad nose tool. This is the workpiece which is rotating in the chuck, maybe a 3-jaw chuck or maybe the 4-jaw chuck or maybe the magnetic chuck. Now, you can see the feed which is parallel to the axis of the rotation. Now, you can see the form tool or maybe the broad nose tool which is having already the angle alpha. So, whenever you are having the relative motion between the form tool and the workpiece, you will get the tapered portion for the workpiece. But the disadvantage is that you can provide only the tapered operation for very smaller length, up to 20 mm only. So there is a limitation for this taper turning operation with the help of method that is called as taper turning by form or the broad nose tool. As I said, that which is useful for very short length, the tool consists of the half tapered angle. And during this taper turning operation, there will be the sum of the vibrations or the chatter during the cutting operations, and the limitation is for the 20 mm taper only. So these are the references. Thank you.